Hello and welcome to my old subscribers. Welcome into my new subscribers. Welcome. Thank you guys for your support. Thank you for all you do. Today I have a prophetic warning from the Lord that he gave me. Actually, he reminded me of this prophetic word on today. The word that he gave me is demolition. I don't know why my camera lighting up. It has me so bright in this camera, but please excuse it. I am sitting right here under the light at my kitchen table because I'm cooking. So please excuse the light. It's gonna go in and out, but it's okay. We here, nevertheless. Anyway, as I was saying, the Lord gave me, he reminded me actually of this prophetic warning. On today, the word demolition, and we all know what demolition is, so I don't have to, read the definition of demolition, but demolition is none other than demolish or alienating something. And so the Lord reminded me of this warning that he gave me back some time ago, but of course I get a little busy and I forget, and so he reminds me, and so I'm here now, about to put it out. But so we're gonna go straight to the verses. We are not gonna read the definition again, as I said. We're gonna go straight in the scriptures because I like to give scriptures to back up what the Lord is saying when he gives me a word. So in Jeremiah 21 and 22, chapter 21, the Lord began to tell Jeremiah to warn Judah that or warn Jerusalem that what he was going to do if they didn't, straighten up. And so in starting at verse 3, it was talking about how the Lord himself said that he will fight against Jerusalem. So when you see things breaking out, it is not people are it didn't just happen. The Lord, send warnings before destruction. And so sometimes we have to be reminded that, who God is. I'm gonna put it like that. Sometimes we take God's grace for out of context. We take advantage of God's grace that, oh, and pretty much this is why people hate the Old Testament, because of who God was back then, which he's still the same God today, yesterday, and forevermore. But thank God for Jesus Christ, who came and died for the sins of the whole world so that we would have a chance, because back then we didn't have a chance. We did not have a chance, or it was hard for them back then, because it was hard, because remember, when you're dealing with flesh, flesh want what it want. It want to do what it want to do. And so it was hard for them to live up to the Ten Commandments. That is why God sent his son, Jesus Christ, who was Jesus in the flesh and God in the spirit. So for those of you who don't know who Jerusalem is, it's a city of peace, a holy city for Jews, Christians, and Muslims, the capital of the ancient kingdom of Judah and of the modern state of Israel. The name means city of peace. Jerusalem means city of peace. And Jerusalem is often called Zion or Mount Zion, is the hill on which the fortress of the city was built. So that is who Jerusalem is, for those of you who don't know who Jerusalem is. So when God say Israel, he's talking about Jerusalem. When God say Judah, he's talking about Jerusalem. So all of it is Jerusalem. So we know back in Lamentation, Jeremiah was warning, sending warning to the people on what would happen in Lamentation. On what would happen. And lamentation as well means desolate as well, which desolate means empty. And so he was warning the people back then. They didn't take heed to the warning that God was sending, nor did they take warning to God's mouthpiece, his prophets, Ezekiel, Elijah, David, all of them, they Moses, they didn't take heed to the word of God or to what God was speaking to them in that hour. And so the people got caught up. Israel got caught up. And when Moses was leading them out of Egypt into the promised land, Israel got caught up, with these other gods. And, God has always warned us to serving another God over him. God does not like it. He does not like it, and he would not come in second place for anybody. And so from the beginning, God was warning Israel about their God, which of course we know the story. For those of you who don't know, when Israel got Aaron to build them this golden calf so they can have it as a god to worship. And we all know that Moses threw the Ten Commandments at it and blew it up. Plus, it killed some other people who, okay, if you want that to be your God, then okay, you shall die with your God. And the ones who wanted to serve the true and living God, they came on the side where Moses was. But to make a long story short, God has always warned us concerning having another God over him. And this is pretty much what this is about. God was warning Jerusalem or Judah about having another God over him. So God told them, I, God, will fight against you. I'll fight against your God. I'll go against you. You will begin to see the wrath of God on people who want to serve another God over him. And that is pretty much what happened to Israel. As you can see in Lamentation, when God allowed Jerusalem's enemies to come and overtake them, which, as I said earlier, Jeremiah was giving warning to that as well. He was telling them what thus says the Lord. They put Jeremiah in a dungeon, because they didn't want to hear what he had to say. They did all kinds of things to God, prophet. As of today, they are still killing us with their mouth, with slaying us and everything else. But we still here and we're not going anywhere. And so over here in 22, I started at 21. You can go back and read 21 because 21 leads up to 22. He was warning in 21, and then he ended up over here in 22. And it says, God's warning for disobedience. But if you will not hear these words, I swear by myself, who is talking, God, says the Lord, that this house shall become a desolation. So, as I said, desolation means empty. God will wipe it out. That is why it's talking about demolition. Demolition means demolish. You'll see everything just laying flat. Like it'll be a desolate place where nothing is. This is what the Lord is saying. It said, for thus says the Lord unto the king's house of Judah, which is Israel and Jerusalem. Thou art Gilead unto me and the head of Lebanon, yet surely I will make thee a wilderness and cities which are not inhabited. And I will prepare destroyers against thee, even one with his weapons, and they shall cut down thy choice cedars and cast them into the fire. Hold on, let me get my foot. Hold on just a second. Okay, so yeah, this was God warning for Jerusalem disobedience to God. And it says, let's see where I left off at. Okay. And many nations shall, verse 8, and many nations shall pass by this city, and they shall say every man to his neighbor, wherefore hath the Lord done thus unto this great city? Then they shall answer, because they have forsaken the covenant of the Lord their God, and worship other gods, and serve them. Weep ye not for the dead, neither bemoan him, but weep sore for him that goeth away, for for he shall return no more, nor see his native country. For thus says the Lord, touching Shalom, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, which reigned instead of Josiah, his father, which went forth out of this place, he shall not return thither anymore, but he shall die in the place whither they have led him captives, and shall see this land no more. So the Lord was warning Israel because of their disobedience, because of their God. He was warning them through Jeremiah that if you don't get it together, then this is what's going to happen. We have seen it before in Lamentation. It happened as well over in Lamentation. It happened where their enemy came in, God allowed their enemies to come in, and they killed a lot of people, and they but God allowed his people to exile. Like, he allowed them to get out, because God sent warning again to his people that, hey, this is about to happen, as he is doing now. And the people exiled out of the land before things took place. And God's people was fine. So God's people will be fine. This is just to the people who are disobedient to God, who, you know, want to serve other gods over God, who, you know, when God warned them to get it right, they still think, you know, take God as a joke, or whatever like that. And so let me read the Message version of it. It said, walking out on the covenant of God. God's order, go to the royal palace and deliver this message, said, listen to what God says, O King of Jerusalem. I mean, O King of Judah, you who sit on David's throne, you and your officials and all the people who go in and out of these palace gates, this is God's message. Attend to matters of justice. Set things right between people. Rescue victims from their exploiters. Don't take advantage of the homeless, the orphans, the widows. Stop the murdering. Stop the murdering. If you obey these commandments, then kings who follow in the line of David will continue to go in and out of these palace gates, mounted on horses and riding in chariots, they and their officials and citizens of Judah. So God is saying, if you get it right, I will continue to bless the land. But if you keep doing what you're doing, going against God, being disobedient to God, then God said, I will allow, and it will be me, not anybody else. It won't be just Russia themselves. It won't be just China themselves, but this will be God. This will be God. So God is letting us know, this is that when it happens, it will be me. It's not nothing that old China plotted against us, Russia plotted against us. It will be God allowing the United States enemies to take them over, because God said, I will not keep having another God over me. You will not keep serving another God over me and throwing it in God's face like he's nothing. And so he said, I will allow your enemies to come in and overtake you. It said, if you obey these commandments, then kings who follow the line of David, so that line was blessed. David's line was blessed. Will continue to go in and out of these palace gates, mounted on horses and riding in chariots, they and their officials and the citizens of Judah. But if you don't obey these commandments, then I swear, God's decree, this palace will end up a heap of rubble, so a heap of nothing. This is God's verdict on Judah's royal palace. I number you among my favorite places, like the lovely hills of Galad, like the soaring peaks of Lebanon. Yet I swear I'll turn you into a wasteland, as empty as a ghost town. I'll hire a demolition crew well equipped with sledgehammers and wrecking bars pound the country to a pulp and burn it all up. Travelers from all over will come through here and say to one another, why would God do such a thing to this wonderful city? They'll be told because they walked out on the covenant of their God with a capital G, God himself, took up with other gods, small g, and worshiped them. So God will allow your enemies to laugh at you. Oh, United States, God will allow your enemies to laugh at you because you have gotten away with a lot. And God is tired. God is tired of you throwing your gods up in his face. And God says it's about to come to an end. It's about to be done away with because God has sent warnings and warnings after warnings after warnings through his people, and the United States won't listen. They won't listen to what the Lord is saying. And so the next thing to do is destruction against the United States. And that is the word of the Lord. Again, you can go back and read Jeremiah 21 and 22 for yourself so you can get a better understanding of what the Lord is saying. But as I said, you can cross-reference the verses, but over in Lamentation as well, which is the book that God gave me earlier in the year to read, that Jeremiah was already warning. He was warning the people, and they never took heed. And so God allowed the land to be taken over. And the same thing would happen this time around. God will allow your enemies to take you over. So God is letting you know, like, you know, it happened to Jerusalem back then, and it'll happen again. When God said it, you can believe it. If God say it, you can believe it. And we have the testimony of the prophet Jeremiah to let us know that, hey, this did happen. This did happen, and it will happen again if you don't be careful, if you don't stop and turn from your wicked ways. It will happen again. Because this place has turned like Sodom and Gomorrah. That's over in Lamentation, what Jeremiah was talking about. Sodom and Gomorrah. They was doing anything, serving their gods, sex, drinking, partying. That's all they was doing back then. And God was warning them, stop. Stop it. Using his servant Jeremiah to tell the people to stop it. But they did not stop. And because of their disobedience, Sodom and Gomorrah was destroyed. It was alienated. It was demolished by God. So when you see these things happening, it is not man. It is God to warn you and to let you know when you see these things happening, it is not man. It is God. It is God's hand. It is God's wrath upon the United States, upon Jerusalem, upon Judah, upon Israel. It is God's hands that is upon you for disobedience and serving your God over God. All right. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.